Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, we have basically seen how we were able to pass the JSON data from screen 1 to screen 2. And in the screen 1, we converted student object into a JSON string. And in screen 2, we basically converted that JSON string back to the object. And that is how we were able to do this. But if you see any production grade application, we rarely do this, especially when it comes to passing the data in a JSON format from one composable to another composable. This is not the recommended way of doing it. So in this video, we will explore how to do it in a much more better manner. So before we write the code, let's try to understand what we are actually trying to do. So to solve the problem that I stated earlier, we basically get started by creating a repository. Creating a repository design pattern is pretty common in Android development. You basically create this repository to store your data and manipulate the data. In our case, we will keep it very simple. We use getStudent and setStudent from a student list. And by doing this, we are basically making this into a one module, which separates out data management aspect of the application. And then we make sure that we can access this repository from the application. So you can see that my application extends the application. So by this design, we should be able to fetch the repository from any of the composables. How to actually do it, I will show you, but get repository is a hint to fetch the repository from anywhere we want. And then this whole thing basically becomes a component which can be plugged and played anywhere in any composable. Now, coming back to the screen navigation, when you navigate from screen 1 to screen 2, you don't have to pass the whole data, you just pass the ID. In this case, it could be the roll number of the student. And once you land in the screen 2, you can fetch the repository. And once you get the repository, you use getStudent method from the repository and pass the roll number, that is 101. The advantage with this particular method is you completely bypass the need to do the serialization. So let's get into a demo and see how exactly this looks when implemented. So I have already done some setup of the application to get started. Let me just close all the tabs. So if you see here, this is the old student class. And then I have an interface called as repository. And then I have app repository, which implements repository. And what I have here is a list of student. Get student basically returns me the student based on the roll number that you pass. And then you have set student, which sets the student in case if you want to do adding a student to this particular list. Right now we won't be interested in doing that. We will be mainly be using get student. And then what you also have is the application. The application is not yet set up, but we can do the setup of the application. So let's get started. Kotlin class, my application. Let me do this very quickly. So now we have the application class, and here is a repository, and we are using lateinit. If you are not familiar with lateinit, you can watch one of my earlier videos. Now we have to register this application. So let me open the manifest file. I have to add my application set. Now open the screen 1. Let me remove this JSON. This is not needed. What I will do is val roll number. Let me pass 101. And then this will be passed along here. Roll number. That's it. And now in screen 2, what we will do is remove all of this complicated logic. Val. Before we even come here, we need to pass the data that we get in the screen 1 via scaffold. So let me open here my nav graph. This is very, very important where we are basically passing the data. So let me just remove this. And here instead of data, I am getting roll number just to make it a little bit descriptive. That's all. I will have to fetch this particular roll number. So val string roll number. So backstack entry dot arguments dot get string roll number. If not available, then set it to 0. You might be wondering, if I am sending it as an integer, then why I am accessing it as a string here? Well, anything that you pass here is always treated as a string. That is a very important thing to note. So once you have this, you can now convert it into a integer. So val data is equal to string roll number dot to int, and then nav controller, that is controller in this case, dot current backstack entry arguments apply, and inside the apply put int roll number slash data. So what we just did is we added the data that we received via the nav controller from screen one into the current backstack entry, and then using this we will be navigating to screen two. And now in screen two we will have to fetch this particular number. You can pretty much copy paste this particular code here. The only difference is, instead of it, you will be using nav controller dot current backstack entry and then arguments. Let us just log and see whether we are getting the roll number here or not. Screen two, roll number received. Let me run this code. So now when I click on screen two, you can see that I am receiving the roll number. Now we will have to pass this to the repository, but for that we will have to fetch the repository from the application context. How do we do that? Well, context is equal to local context dot current. That will give me the context, it is application context, and from that I need to get my application context. How do we do that? Context dot application context as my application. And now from here I can do is student my application dot get repository dot get student pass the roll number. And now once you have that, put it here. And now let me rerun the application. And now when I click here, we should get the student. Let me see what happened. Yeah, I forgot to add it in the text. Now if you see here, you are getting the student. And now if you just go back to the student class, this serializable is not required at all now. Even without serialization, this works just perfectly fine. And you are not passing any complicated data. You are just simply passing the age-old simple string integer. So your navigation becomes now much more clear. So the reason why we did all that we did is, one, to achieve a better separation of concern, and by repository we are able to do the data management much better. We have also improved the testability of the data repository itself. And then because we are not sending the data as a part of the Jetpack navigation, navigation's performance is much better. You are simply sending very small amount of data, and then you simplify the navigation itself and you achieve a modularization. That is why this is a recommended approach. In this case, I have kept it very simple using the repository design pattern. But if you are familiar with view model and live data concepts, then this same thing can be achieved using those concepts as well. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.